Ah oui, okay. So you have a web interface. There is a documentation that I used to write in pure ASCII because that's my documentation language. I can put the URL here. I put it on my Twitter account, which was forwarded by Erwan, I guess. So you have it on Kernel Recipes. Non, n'importe quoi. OK. With Wi-Fi, it's better, often. Non, bon. OK. Should be better. So you end up on this page. A lot of them are protected by passwords. They are for our commercial versions. You go to the Pocket directory here. I don't know if everyone sees because it's very small. I don't know what... Yes, oh, I can zoom like this. Fantastic browser. So let me do it again. At the bottom of the page, Pocket. You have the procedure to connect... Wow. Ah, I should look here. There is some delay. The quick start. You see? .txt. Okay. So some blabla for new users, etc. It explains how to connect to it. What are the Ethernet addresses? How you can flash it, because if you want to upgrade it. And more importantly, the quick start for the main product. Because in fact it is the same software, so it explains how to use the interface. Don't repeat it too loud, but I don't know this doc in fact. You pick any of them, I don't care. You should have some information on how to use the product. The doc is, I would say, it's pretty complete as a quick start, but it will not tell you exactly what to do with it. So, aside this, I'm pretty sure most of you will want instead to look a bit closer inside. SSH is available by default. You have the IP address on the sticker behind. You have the user and password, admin, admin. You can connect to any of these two addresses. You have some updates. In fact, they are older than the version shipped here because there was a bug that I discovered just after coming here. And you have everything to rebuild the firmware here in the developer's directory. You have all the sources which come with it. Oh, an old image, I can remove it. Sorry. This way? Okay. So, readme. It explains what is needed and the process to build it. All the sources for the tool chains, and some pre-built packages. I don't remember the details to be honest, because as you can see, I wrote and uploaded that 2 months ago already, and some water has flown under the bridges since then. But anyway, everything is detailed in the README, and I used someone to test exactly this procedure, and it worked. So that's important for me, because I know that sometimes we can have some assumptions. You will find almost only open source. I'm saying almost because there are a few proprietary packages distributed as binaries only. I know it is stupid, but it's a web interface and maybe one or two daemons, which are not critical, in fact, and which you will probably don't care about. That's enterprise stuff. Another important thing regarding this device, the kernel is 3.14, I don't know which one, it was almost the last one, I did not update after last version from Greg. It was patched using patches present in OpenWRT to support this architecture because it's a MIPS, but in fact there are many flavors of MIPS, and it's ATH79, which is not in mainline. So there are something like 200 patches on it, but they don't move. So it's easy to rebase from time to time to the latest mainline kernel. So the exact chip is an Atheros AR9331. It has Wi-Fi on board, but we don't use it. In a load balancer, it's not really interesting, in fact. And it's even better not to have it because you don't, in a, something like this, you don't want someone to connect to your load balancer via Wi-Fi. So it was not enabled, and these devices were flashed in the factory, so they did not set the, at the end of the flash, there is a 64K partition containing the Wi-Fi parameters, which are produced after Wi-Fi calibration, and they did not produce it. So maybe some of them will work if you want to try the Wi-Fi, maybe they will not. Anyway, what I will ask you, kindly ask you, I would say, is that if you want to use this just to replace your Wi-Fi router, better buy one. It's $20. It's cheap. For most of us, it's cheap. I think that it is more important to offer it to a student or whoever in your neighborhood who is interested in learning networking than just reflashing it with the regular firmware. Anyone can buy a very small device with OpenWRT on it, and it's not worth the thing. I don't mind if you remove all the stuff from our company on it. It's not a problem. It's just the principle that they were distributed to encourage discovery of our network equipment work and to train people to do better stuff at this. I don't know what else to add. Maybe I had a lot of questions and many times the same questions, in fact. So that's why I wanted to address them. But maybe some people have some questions. I don't know. Oh, yes, there was one question. The micro USB port is only for power. I verified the copper lanes on it and they are not connected. So don't waste your time trying to use it as a TG. And yes, there is a serial port inside. Here is one opened. Okay. You have a small connector here. It's the serial port, GND RX TX. So if you want to use it with a USB to 3 volt TTL converter, you can use it. The console is enabled by default. Probably some of you have questions. I don't know. No?
I'm actually a student at the school.
Ah, sorry.
I'm actually a student in the school. Do you want me to drop some of your product in the administration?
As you like. If you are interested, apparently they were all gone this time, but just send me an email with your address. We shipped many of them via regular post already, so we can send you some.
I'll take your email just after the conference.
No problem. That was the original purpose, you see, so. Similarly, if some people want two of them, not everyone, because we will quickly run short, but if some people have some project and want to have two of them to test high availability or whatever, it's possible.
I guess this device has some sort of internal switch. Do you use it for anything, or is this, does it?
In fact, it's inside the SoC. The two ports, from what I have understood from the diagrams, The two ports are connected to an internal switch. And the, in fact, there are 5 ports on this switch, but only 2 are routed outside. We don't use it as a switch. In fact, they appear as different Ethernet interfaces. I don't even know how to change the configuration. And I was not interested that much, to be honest. Okay? Okay, thank you.